In addition to calculating limiting reactants and how much of a product is produced, we can determine how much of one of the other two reactants is left unreacted. So in this example, we're going to ask how much NH3 is left unreacted if 1.0 kilograms of NH3 reacts with 1.0 kilogram of oxygen and 1.0 kilogram of methane in the following reaction. So same reaction from the previous problem. We know that from the previous problem, the limiting reactant is going to be O2, and that 20.8 moles of HCN is going to be produced. So the first step that we want to ask ourselves is we want to know that how much NH3 is required to produce 20.8 moles of HCN. So we're going to start then with the 20.8 moles of HCN. And we know from our balanced chemical equation that for every 2 moles of HCN, we have 2 moles of NH3. We now need to convert the moles of NH3 over to grams of NH3. So 1 mole of NH3 is 17.0 grams of NH3. When we do our conversion factor and do the math, we get 354 grams of NH3. Now, when we start calculating these things, we want to know, and I'm going to try to emphasize, how would we express this number in a sentence? This is 354 grams of NH3, and when we express this, we can say that 354 grams of NH3 is required to produce 20.8 moles of HCN. So we know that oxygen limits this particular reaction. It's the limiting reactant, and we're going to have 20.8 moles of HCN produced. We need to figure out how much ammonia that's going to be required to produce that amount. We calculated that to be 354 grams. So in terms of the amount of NH3 left unreacted, we're starting with 1.00 kilogram, or 1,000 grams of NH3. We're going to subtract 354 grams, which is the amount that was required to produce the 20.8 moles, and that's going to give us 646 grams of NH3 that is unreacted after 1,000 grams of O2 is consumed. So we still have 646 grams of the ammonia left after all of the oxygen is used up. So we will call this an excess reactant. So in this particular problem, oxygen is the limiting reactant, and the excess reactants are NH3 and CH4. And when we can do the exact same calculation for CH4 to see how many grams of that are unreacted in this particular problem.